Today I'm going to show you how to create reorder lists for your inventory based on both the quantity on hand and the expiry date. I have a basic sheet here where I have part numbers, I have descriptions, I have expiry date, I have the number received, the number used, and the result is a number on hand. So I have created reorder lists on this one. And so the reorder list, I'm basing it on, if there's four or less quantity, then we need to reorder these. So let's just put in on this brown stuff line here, let's say that we've used another one here. And I have dragged these down further so that it's extended, but there's nothing there. So let's put one in here, and that will change the quantity to four. And all of a sudden, your brown stuff now appears in your quantity reorder list. Same thing going. We have your reorder list based on the expiry here. And let's just change. Let's just go and change this expiry date to September 20 or 19 as opposed to 21. And press tab. And then we go back to our inventory sheet. And then we now have our red stuff on the inventory sheet. So let me explain the formulas. It's quite detailed. So I'm going to click on the formula for the brown stuff here. And let me break this down for you. So the center of this formula is the small function. And the small function, the center of this formula, if you see here, is the small function. And this is based on an array, so that we have an array, and it's the kth smallest version of the number in that list here. And so we have, what we have done here is we've said small, and we've set our array that it's, if it's between F2 and F11, if it is less than or equal to 4, so that's our array. And our K value is the row number, so it's between F2 and F11. Now, the next function that we've used centering this is the index function. And the index function works with, goes index, table, row number, column number. And so what we have done here is I've done index, and I'm saying we want to return the B column, which is the description of what we have in stock here. And then we're using the small function as the row number. It's going to determine which is the smallest version or the smallest quantity that they have on hand. And then the final is the row, and it's the same row as the column is. So that is how that this is done. Now, for the second one, for reordering for the expiry date, what I've done, instead of making it less than or equal to 4, I've made it less than or equal to today. And basically, we still have the same small function here, and we have the index function going around the small function. Now, all of these are array functions. For them to work, you must press the Control-Shift-Enter to put the outside curly brackets on this whole function. It will not work if you try to type in the outside curly brackets, so Control Shift Enter is the only way that you're going to get this to work. So although it's quite complicated, it is a very useful function to have on your inventory sheets. So that is how you create an inventory list by both product or number of product on hand and by expiry date. Please subscribe.